In the 16th century, an Italian mathematician named Cardano had a well-known gambling addiction. He wrote letters in which he bragged about his ability to beat his friends at dice games. His trick was to place his bets using his ideas from mathematics instead of hunches or luck. He came up with a method of calculating the exact probability of random events, such as, say, rolling snake eyes. It is based on a powerful property Cardano noticed. Every outcome, no matter how many dice you roll, is equally likely. This allowed him to calculate the probability by developing what's now called a probability space. First, he counts all possible outcomes, known as the sample space. For a single dice, these are the six possible faces. Then he defines the event in question, such as rolling a 1, which can occur in one way. The probability is then found by dividing the event by all possible events, which in this case works out to 1/6. Realize the cold calculating logic here. There was no such thing as a lucky number, no divine intervention. The probability of rolling any number is exactly 1/6. Now the same logic applies when we roll multiple dice. Imagine he needed to know the probability of rolling a pair. First, he counts the size of the sample space. With 2 dice rolls, there are 36 possible outcomes. 6 times 6. Then he counts the number of ways this event can occur. There are 6 different pairs. So 6 divided by 36 is the probability of rolling a pair. Also 1/6. This simple yet powerful idea allowed Cardano to bet according to the true probability, while his opponents placed their bets based on hunches and lucky numbers. Remember, this works with multiple rolls. Imagine we needed to know the exact probability of rolling 3 ones. Simple. First, we figure out the size of the sample space. For 3 dice, this is 6 times 6 times 6, or 216. And there is only one way to roll 3 ones. So the probability is 1 divided by 216. This was the trick. It was not based on magic, but mathematics. Remember, to calculate the probability of a random event, such as a dice roll, you divide the number of ways that event can occur by all possible outcomes.